The pasuk says, "V'ram levavecha v'shachachta es Hashem Elokecha." You'll become arrogant, haughty, pompous, and you'll forget the Rabbono Shel Olam. I want to share with you two fascinating insights into the pasuk. One is based upon the Eben Ezra, and one is based upon the Ran and the Drashas Haran. The Eben Ezra points out that Moshe Rabbeinu is communicating to Bnei Yisrael. He explains the pasuk by saying Moshe is talking to Klal Yisrael, telling them, instructing them, don't forget the Rabbono Shel Olam chesed to you when he took you out of Mitzrayim. It's a particular event, and Rav Gifter elaborates, developing, suggesting that you see a fascinating Moser Haskel. The religious take-home message is that one should not forget not just the chesed that God has done to you, but God has done throughout history. What he's done to your forefathers, to your parents and great-grandparents, and all the generations all the way up. Because all of the success that you have is really based upon blessing that Hashem has given to you and to your everything that made you, all the history that went into allowing you to become who you are and growing into who you're becoming. And therefore, don't forget the Rabbono Shalom's chesed throughout generations, because it all builds and develops you into the person, it facilitates you to grow into the person you want to grow into. However, the Ran has another fascinating insight, which I thought was just remarkable, and so pshat in the pasuk. It's so much mashma from the words of the pasuk. In contrast to how people generally understand the pasuk, which is, the Torah is giving you mussar. Don't think you did this on your own. You think you're so arrogant, you did this on your own. You forgot God. No, realize it's all the Rabbono Shel Olam. Says the Ran, that's incorrect. There are a lot of people out there who are very talented, very wise, very profound in thought. Some people have Eitzah, some people have Chachma, some people have other talents. The world is full of talented people. How could you ignore the fact that you are somehow responsible? Of course you're talented. The problem, says the Ran, is that you don't realize it's the Rabbono Shel Olam who gave you those kochos. It's the Rabbono Shel Olam who facilitated you to use your strength to succeed. Ki hu hanosein lecha koach lasos chayil. You may have been the one who was lasos chayil, but hu hanosein lecha koach lasos chayil. We do have talents. We do have strengths. We do have remarkable capacity and capability for success. And when we do succeed, that is because we worked hard and accomplished. Just realize your natural talents were given to you by the Rabbono Shel Olam, and if you earn to work and work down those natural talents, well, the capacity to be motivated and the raw natural potential was given to you by the Rabbono Shel Olam. Your success is partnership between you and the Rabbono Shel Olam. And as we, Amir Tzashem, succeed in life, no one's suggesting that it's the Rabbono Shel Olam without you. The pasuk's just warning you, it's not you without the Rabbono Shel Olam. We should continue seeing our lives as partnerships with the Rabbono Shel Olam, to succeed, to accomplish, to achieve, because ki hu anosei lecha koach lasos chayil.